Spiegs, what's the last film you made it all the way through? Like a work Ooh. Of fiction.
Let's see. Well, you've put me on the spot here. I don't know. I've watched more series than okay. movies. I've watched that black and white film.
Oh, yeah.
Ripley.
Yeah. Ripley.
That's right.
You made it
Ripley.
All the way through.
Yeah.
Okay. Work of fiction, but a series. But as far as a movie, maybe outside of a documentary, maybe something like a
maybe Spider-Man 2.
Spider-Man.
Or a more recent Spider-Man. I don't know.
This movie drops late last year. Comes out, I believe, early January in the States. Godzilla Minus One. Out of nowhere, it shows up on Netflix. I learned this word. Shadow drop means they don't tell anybody. It's just there. And it gets ridiculous reviews. Our associate program director, Justin Johnson, movie guy, more than I am even, he sees it. He comes back into the office, kicks the door off the hinges. Everybody go see this right now. It's amazing. And what was great about it was that it had, like, no budget. Like, I think an episode of The Talented Mr. Ripley or Ripley cost as much as this movie. It's like $10 to $12 million, 15 with marketing.
Yeah, it's pretty evident. It had no budget.
Oh!
Wow.
The Spiegel 20, famously, you give a movie 20 minutes before you say, my time is my most valuable asset, and it shall not be wasted anymore.
Yeah.
We say, hey, give this thing a shot. And by all accounts, you made it how far?
22 minutes.
22 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay, so past 20, but that's it.
Yeah, I watched it twice. I watched it once by myself, and then I wanted Stella to see it. I watched it with her. And,
people are reminding us you didn't watch the Pop-Tart movie. The Pop-Tart movie.
Huh?
Frosted. Oh, I watched that. That was the last one.
What about it? You just couldn't do it?
Well, a synopsis of what I watched. It starts with a plane landing on an island, an airfield, in the final days of World War II. There are men dressed in white for some reason, and they're suspicious of the pilot because there are no mechanical issues with the plane.
Did you get why they were suspicious with him, the gimmick with him?
Yes, because he was not a kamikaze. He didn't.
He was a kamikaze.
Well,
and
he didn't go.
So
the scenery, it was lush, green mountains, very beautiful.
That's a good note.
Yeah, I'm reading off the top of my head. I'm talking off the top of my head.
Ignore the sound of that paper.
Yes. As the pilot is sitting by the water, he sees what appeared to be dead fish. And not sure what that was all about, but when night falls, a siren sounds. The people believe that they may be under attack. Then there's a loud, horrifying noise with absolutely no fanfare or buildup at all, and Godzilla just appears, emerging from the water. He's very ugly and appears to be drooling. And a guy with glasses, a real know-it-all, explains what Godzilla is while everybody's panicking. The men persuade the kamikaze pilot to leave their hiding spot to shoot Godzilla. And it's hard to believe.
Godzilla does not see the pilot, and I believe that's because Godzilla does not have peripheral vision.
Mm-hmm.
And when the pilot doesn't fire on Godzilla, the others start. That's a mistake. That really pisses off Godzilla. He starts grabbing men with his mouth.
Hell yeah, he does.
Their heads, tossing them into the water.
Woo!
Next morning, the pilot awakes and looks around, finds himself to be the only one alive, except for one other man who's angry that everybody else is dead. Dead men are lined up in a row. I can only assume that Godzilla did that, some sort of a satanic ritual.
Hell yeah. Rock and roll.
Then you find who I assume is the kamikaze pilot on a boat with a bunch of other untalented actors. It looks like they're going home to some sort of shanty town. And that's where a woman yells at him for being a coward and not kamikazeing.
Got his ass.
That's right.
Yep.
Then a woman
pussy
hands him a baby while running away from someone.
That's right.
He runs into, it gets a little clear. I start confusing the women.
Okay.
He runs into a woman who yelled at him, and he hands her the baby. They hang out and talk. He plays hard to get. It appears they're living in a shed. So he gets a job, but the woman yells at him not to go. And that's where I ended it. So
so you made it through a pretty good chunk of the setup and plot in some development. Okay, so now you did give it a fair shake.
You're damn right I did.
It won an Academy Award for Best Visual
Effects. What? It won an Academy Award?
It's an Academy Award-winning film, March 10th, 2024, Best Visual Effects.
Oh, is this the one where Godzilla was supposed to walk down the red carpet at the Academy Awards?
If that happened and that I didn't see awesome. I'm furious.
Did a little tux or something?
That would rule. Yeah, and then someone asks him a question, Godzilla, and just destroys Maria Menounos.
I mean, there's a lot. It's like it's a Godzilla film, but there's a lot of other implications. It's about atomic war. It's about a kamikaze pilot, you know.
Survivor's guilt.
Survivor's guilt, not following, you know, shame. And then there's a kid involved, and then he tries to redeem himself.
Mm-hmm. His war is never over.
It's pretty, the guy that he's left on the island with when everyone else is dead, he comes back around at the end, and you're like, okay.
This guy hates him.
It was
him.
A little more polished than I thought it was going to be. Like, was this like a summer blockbuster in Japan or something? It's like a very blockbustery type movie.
It came
like
out
like a summer tent pole for me, and I'm not a big fan of those. But the story was good.
It was released in October in... they released it at the Godzilla headquarters, the place I showed you I visited when I went there. They released it at the headquarters for the building, the fans. November 3rd was when it came out. So it was like a holiday film over there. I think it was, and someone can correct me here, I think it was the 60th anniversary of Godzilla.
Oh.
That's why they put it out there.
We didn't throw a party.
We didn't even get him an edible arrangement.
Like, I'm thinking about movies like Independence Day or Armageddon or something like that, where it's like, but it's Godzilla instead.
They dumped this thing in January, which is a no man's land for films. They're just like, we don't think it's going to do anything. So, and it made a rack of money.
In summary, on a score of 1 to 5, I give it a 0.1.
Oh, Jesus.
And you could have gotten a high school drama club to do a better job than these actors.
He's not wrong. The acting was, we've talked about that.
We did talk about the Japanese actors.
Japan.
And they tend to send it in every scene. There's some scenes that you would think would call for nuance.
Mm-hmm.
And the nuance compared to maybe, I don't know, another actor from another region. Not as soft. Joe, did you see it?
I did not.
Okay. There's a scene where the guy that survived, he is going to ask for someone's help. And he goes to bow to them in an act of humbleness and an act of contrition. Please help me. There's a gigantic nuclear mutant lizard with laser breath off the coast. And he goes to bow. And when I say he bounces his head off of a table, I don't know if it was intentional or not. Because I started laughing when he donked his head on this table. It's real dramatic. Or when he goes to this one office trying to track this man down. I need his help. He's the only man that can fix this plane, and this plane's the only thing that can help us stop. He's in there screaming in this office in a way I was like, whoa, let's, you're at a 10. How about a 6? No one's going to hear you over the yelling. It's a little wild. I loved it. I thought, did you ever see any of the American Godzillas? In like the past 10 or 15 years, they've released them. Kurt Russell's been in them.
Yeah, I don't remember which one. I saw one. I don't remember which one. I'm so sorry.
There was one with Matthew Broderick that Cisco did the soundtrack for. Not great.
I'm so apologetic. I don't remember.
The American Godzilla tends to act like a gymnast.
Yeah.
Like he's just like doing parkour through a city and doing like Taekwondo. I loved this Godzilla because he was just this big, fat, potato-assed mutant reptile that just wants to wreck ass everywhere he goes. There's no reason. There's no, like, I wonder what he's thinking. It's just an awful lizard. We got to stop him.
Well, the one of the things that disappointed me was when Godzilla was attacking the people on the military base and grabbing them by the heads and throwing them in water. I just wanted him to rip their heads off.
Just to eat them.
Yeah.
T-Rex style from Jurassic Park. Maybe I'll forward you just a single scene later on. He does get a lot bigger.
Okay.
And he heads downtown and he just proceeds to level a city.
In the same movie?
Same movie.
Okay. I'll enjoy that.
He does hit puberty at some point.
Dude, when they're sitting there, there's that one scene and it's like kind of quiet. And I think they're sitting on the boat, like getting ready to go out or something. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden, the whole front of a ship just comes flying
through the air.
I was like, holy crap.
Hell yeah.
That was an awesome shot.
It was cool.